So I know we've all seen the Doja Cat video that has been causing so much riffraff. If you haven't, take a look. I am on the bigger things. I just bought a limousine. A limousine. You live like me in your dreams. Yes, you do. I just quit the nicotine. I did. If you throwing dick at me, do it, nigga. That shit should be big at least. Do it, nigga. Nigga, I'ma bring the heat. I'ma bring the cold. You should bring your skis. I'm a fucking queen. Queen. I am expeditiously. See it, bitch. Are you off a key? Let's talk about it. So what this video is depicting is sleep paralysis. I don't know if some of you may be familiar with it or not, but I know a lot of people experience this. But basically, one who gets tormented within their sleep, in their dreams, the demons are holding them down and attacking them, tormenting them. It seems to be a never-ending cycle if you don't have the right tools to get free from this, which is Jesus Christ. A lot of people will say when they are experiencing sleep paralysis, they can only say the name of Jesus, and usually they'll be able to move because these demons are trying to kill them, but they're holding them down and suppressing them. A lot of people get choked during sleep paralysis. So I believe that this is something that Doja Cat is experiencing because of the open doors within her life. But a lot of the times these artists and celebrities, they take what they're going through personally and try to transform it into some type of art depiction for the people to be able to view what they're going through and how their lives are. Some of them may say it's far-fetched or it's their label, but a lot of the times it's something that they're personally dealing with. I believe that this is something that Doja is currently struggling with because, like I said, the open doors that she has in her life, because of her not knowing who she is and not having the direct access and tools that she needs to be able to fight back and to war against these demons that are trying to infiltrate her mind, her spirit, her sleep, everything. Again, this is why the Bible says, "My people perish for lack of knowledge," because when you don't have the right understanding and you don't have the knowledge and you're not equipped within the Word of God, then you just go with the flow with whatever is being thrown your way. They're trying to glamorize demons and sleep paralysis through this video. You can even feel a dark entity over the video. So, you know, for those who haven't been trained up in the spirit, I just ask the Lord to cover the people who are watching this who have felt something. Lord, I ask that you just equip them in these areas so that they can be strong and understand and gain the gift of the discerning of spirits so that they won't be attacked. But we have to be very mindful about watching certain things, especially if you're not equipped, because you can get attacked. I'm sure this all even correlates with a spirit spouse. And that's when you get attacked sexually in your dreams. And it really is disheartening because, like I said, if people are not praying for these celebrities and we're just coming on here talking about them, well, I'm not going to say weird because I don't just talk about people. I definitely intercede for them. In fact, the group page that I have, we dedicated a week to interceding for celebrities. I will also pin that group in the comments if any ladies want to join. It's only for ladies. It's for fellowship, accountability, Bible studies, deliverance, healing, all of that. She needs to be prayed for. And I'm not just saying by me, but by every one of these influencers who's out here talking about her or even drawing attention by reposting her videos and saying how demonic they are. We have to get out of just talking about things. We are equipped and we have the power through the Holy Spirit to make things shift, to change things, to change people's lives. So why are we not doing that? You know, I can definitely see that. Anybody can see that Doja is lost and she is in need of prayers from the righteous. She is in need of prayers. I believe that there will be a shift in her life. I believe that once we do start warring in the spirit for these people, that we will see a change. And sometimes it tends to get worse before it gets better. But
at the end of the day, we know that we're being heard because the Lord hears our prayers. He desires all mankind to be saved. That is His will. So that means if you're praying on behalf of someone who is blind, it is God's will to hear your prayer and to help make sure that that prayer is received and put into the earth. Whether it be sending somebody there to plant the seeds and to water the seeds, and ultimately God brings the increase. But it is God's desire for all of mankind to be saved. So if you're praying on behalf of someone, He's going to make sure that your prayers are heard. Another thing that I have realized is if you are just making videos about certain celebrities that are doing things that are demonic, the Lord says that you have fell into the traps of Satan. You have fell into the snares of the enemy because you're not praying for that person. You are only speaking against whatever it is that they're doing. And you're shifting the focus from God's power and sovereignty to the demonic realm. So when you're not doing what you need to be doing and interceding on behalf of these people, and you're just talking about them, you, as the elect, have now been deceived and fell into the traps of the enemy because you are not doing anything. Faith without works is dead. And that also goes with your prayer life. That also goes with the ministry that you have. You can't just always be talking about things without doing them. So we need to do better as the body of Christ. So before one gets all holier than thou and righteous and self-righteous and I'm this and I'm that because I'm pointing out somebody's flaw, I'm pointing out their demon because they literally are dressed as a demon, but you're not praying. You're not allowing the Holy Spirit to work through you to intercede for that soul, because regardless of whatever you think or whatever kind of depiction that you have in your mind as to where you think it's too late for that person, you are now falling into the snares of the enemy. You have now reshifted your focus to the demonic kingdom and realm instead of focusing on the power of the Holy Ghost. We have the power and the ability to change things. But the problem is everybody is all about talk and nobody's out here doing what they need to be doing. So I advise everybody get into the presence of the Lord and reshift your focus. Amen. And I'm just gonna say this one last thing, just a little food for thought, a little nugget that the Holy Spirit dropped. What good is it to only preach the gospel to those who know it? What good is it to only continue to recycle these same words and doctrines to the people who already know Jesus? What good is it? What good is it? That's just like loving someone who's easy to love. We are called to the lost. We are called to those who do not know Jesus. We are called to those that are less and weak in the faith. Those that would be considered less than. We are called to those people. So if your ministry is not wrapped around being called to the ones who don't know God, you even need to rethink your ministry, because we are all called to do that.